Hey guys, welcome to the video. Something exciting, as you can see. I got the nice COVID beard going on. So, I'll be showing you the S5, pretty much how it is and the damage done to it and what I need for it. So, take a look. So I have the front bumper, I took it off and I just put it back on. That is really damaged. All the tabs are damaged and I'm gonna go into more detail over that. As you can see, it's a little dusty and there's a Dremel over there. I'll explain all that later. So as you can see here, this was hit, probably with like a hammer of some sort a couple times, you know. Let's just say this is more of an insurance fraud. There's no way this was done by like an angry girlfriend or whatever. Like you can see the scratch all around. So this thing is all around the entire car. It was kicked in here. It's pretty strong for, I mean, it could be a really strong girl, but you know what I mean. That's not easy to do. Especially without a mark, meaning there was no hammer involved. Keyed all around here. Even the lights are keyed, but it's very light. You can definitely polish it out. Here are the wheels. There seem to be reps because there's no center caps and they're pretty dirty. A lot more damage here. There's a dent here and a bend. So the glass is broken and this was broken. So as you can see here, I already got this done. I didn't end up recording it, but I purchased a secondary door. I was going to just throw it on, but I figured it's going to cost more to paint the inside of the door as well. So I got this done and I hoped that the bodywork was minimal for that. In hindsight, I should have just kept the door as is, threw the mirror cap on, and then got the black door painted, because I think that still would have been cheaper in the long run. Sorry, cheaper and less work, because it took me, I'd say, like a good day, like, you know, 4 to 5 hours trying to get all this window stuff done. And we did wash the car, as you saw. And there is a small leak coming right here. You can see it in the well inside. So the water was coming down here, and this is where the speaker goes. I don't think that's right. That doesn't really make sense. I don't think that's safe for the electronics. So I'm gonna hold off and try to figure out the cause of that, and hopefully get to the bottom of it. As you can see, obviously continued the key. And there you go, right? A lot of damage, nice. Still looks pretty good. It runs fine. Opening this up now. Here's the engine compartment, nice and dirty. So there's coolant right now, actually. An issue that I had when I bought this is that it was missing this radiator. So this is the auxiliary radiator, it's for the supercharger. And it was leaking coolant from here when I picked it up. So that was the first thing I got. I picked that up and I picked up some coolant here. It's the OEM G12 type. And filled her up. So now it's good in terms of coolant. The bumper is another story. So I spent a good part of maybe 10 hours working on the stupid bumper. Had tons of little cracks. Damages here, like this kind of stuff. I spent maybe $20 to $30 in epoxy. I fixed everything up really nicely. Stuff like this, all of this, it's all cracked, all damaged. As you can see here, this stuff was broken too, the tabs here, and when I fixed it, it's just not fitting. Like, no matter what I do, it's not really gonna work. And I think that this isn't the right move. I don't think it's gonna work, and it might still be a little bit of body work for a paint shop. So what I'm gonna do is probably just find another bumper online. It really sucks because this bumper totally seems salvageable, but I think that's the only way to make it actually look proper. So I'm gonna probably get that replaced. Let me take off the bumper and I'll show you what's next. And you can see bumper's off. Small things like this. This is a little broken. It's just the wind guide. Now here's a couple things that are key. So here, this was cut. That is the garage link or whatever it's called. So the transmitter for the garage door opener. Had to find that. Try to splice it in. Now the grills. So the grills that aren't here. Obviously, I took those out while I was working on the bumper. Those grills do not have a spot for the fog light. And what I noticed here is, yeah, the fog lights are cut out. And I actually don't mind that, because I don't mind running it without the fog light, especially because I have the grill insert that's a full honeycomb. There's no fog light. So I'll run that. I think it looks kind of aggressive as well, so I'm okay just leaving it as is. And then here is the horns. Yeah, surprising enough. Well, actually, I'm not sure which one's which. I think this one might be the horn, but I'm not sure yet. I'll figure it out once I get it to replace those, because yeah, they don't work. And the same thing for the other side right here. So yeah, two for horn, two for fog light, and that's really it. In terms of everything else, here's a little damage to the fender liner. Under tray's a little messed up, so I'm looking for replacements for those as well. And I think that's the extent of the exterior damage. Now let's look at the interior. Coming inside here, everything looks okay from afar. Don't mind that. But when you start looking into the details, you'll start seeing the damages. So these were jabs, a little bit here, it's a little dirty. Now the first driver's seat slashed here and here. You would have seen that in the previous video. And the passenger seat. And as you can see, the passenger seat has a nice big gash across three different panels. So I've gotten quotes to get these redone, and I can probably get it done for around $600. So we'll see how that goes. Coming to the center console, all are new replaced. As you can see, this scratch here. And then you look at the old center console. Yeah, it was keyed all along that into that carbon fiber inlay there, or piece there. So yeah, looking at the center console, these are sticky. And I was missing this piece. I got this from a used car, very cheap. It was worth the replacement. At the same time, my screen wasn't working. Let me show you the screen. And here's the old screen. As you can see, looks like it took a nice punch. Yeah, they definitely didn't miss their marks. They hit everything they could to damage, maybe to get that claim done, but there's no way this was all done by, you know, who knows, right? It could be vandalism, but I'm like 99.9% sure this is a total insurance fraud. Like, look at this, it's crazy. And you can see here a little slashy slash over here. That's something I might leave for now in terms of resale the car. You know, I can get it fixed. It might not be perfect though, that's the thing. So if I were to sell it, it's something I would lower the price for to make equivalent or to make fair. So yeah, anyways, the screen was replaced and I tested it all out and it would turn on and turn off, and I couldn't really figure out why that was happening. I searched Google, I looked around, and I couldn't really figure out exactly what was going on, except for reading that, you know, I think it has, when the wiring isn't, you know, proper, or there's like a disconnection somewhere, that usually causes this issue where it turns on and off again. So I eventually looked around. Let's go check the back. Something I thought was fine, I eventually did notice here. Oh, look at that, a nice little gaping hole, missing a lot of stuff. So as you can see, this is broken. I don't know how they removed this thing, but they just like yanked it. It's missing the amp, right, for the Bang & Olufsen sound system, as well as the, it's like a navigation radio module. So those two are missing. Once I get those in, connect all this up, that stuff should hopefully work. Now going back to the driver's seat, a little more jabby jabs over here. Condition of the leather and all that is mediocre. Once I clean it up, I'm thinking it'll be a little better. That's really it. The last thing that annoyed me is that I try to move this sunscreen cover here, and yeah, like it's stuck. So the side kind of moves, but this side here, it ripped. So while I was trying to move it, it was stuck and it got ripped, and it was stuck since I got it. So that's very unfortunate. I think this is part of the whole sunroof. So the only, I honestly don't know what I'm gonna do to fix this. Replacing the whole sunroof is definitely not ideal. So I don't know. We'll figure that part out later. Maybe someone can give me some suggestions. But other than that, everything is good. This piece is still out, just in case I need to get back in there once I get everything installed. Nothing else is really damaged as far as I know. So that's really it. The door card for that had a few little stabs too. Yeah, so the little jabs in the door card, they could go noticeable, maybe fixable. So we'll see how it goes. Obviously, I need to keep this color set, which is the, I think it's the Lunar Cosmic, Lunar Silver, I don't know. It's some kind of color like that. It's really nice, I like it. These seats are awesome. I test drove the car the other day and it was great. You saw the clip in the beginning. But yeah, the car pulls, you know, it can drift, so it's not too bad. It's pretty fun. I think it'd be a great car to keep for a bit. I did consider tuning it, getting the pulleys done. The pulley, it kind of feels like it's overkill. Like for my need, I'm not planning to max this car out. I did consider getting the stage one tune because it gives you between 70 and 100 horsepower based on, depending on what company you go with. But that tune starts at like $1,000 plus you want the DSG tune. So you're looking at like 2K Canadian just for that, which isn't bad. Back when I had my Z, which is gone by the way. I don't know if you're keeping up with the channel, the Z is sold. I'm posting up a few videos I have still from it. But other than that, you know, the Z is gone, so I'm trying to make this my temporary toy, maybe keep it. It's good for winter too. This could be my daily. And it's a pretty damn fun car to have. Just for giggles, let's turn her on. There you go. Close the door so it stops yelling at us. Oh, it's gonna show that the hood is up. So service is due, the brake pads, so the front rotors and I guess the rear rotors as well. They have a really big lip on it, so I will be getting those replaced. I already ordered the parts for that. Yeah, 93,000. Sounds pretty good. For a stock exhaust, sounds pretty dang good. So definitely the mature version of, you know, a sports car, but it's really nice. Yeah, that's the part. It's very annoying. So turn her off. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna go back to that bumper. I'm probably have to buy a new one. Gotta get this filled out and pulled, hopefully. But yeah, overall it looks pretty good. I know it needs a full paint job. It's gonna be very expensive. A little bit of filling, a little bit of pulling. I replaced, so this has been replaced from the old door. This bottom part was broken off, as you saw in the last video where I picked it up. But yeah, everything in the engine bay besides what I've shown you is good. So sadly, all this work, it's a lot of epoxy, it's a lot of shoddy work, or ugly work I could say, but it is structurally strong. I had to re-put this part back in. I don't know if this actually is part of the bumper or not, so when I look to buy a new one, I'll figure that out. But yeah, this stuff kind of just broke again as I tried forcing it in. Once I have a new one, I know that it will fit, and I'll just have to make sure that all this is good. I might need to replace this piece here, as you can see. These little tabs that hold in the bumper, this one seems to be missing. It seems to be doing that on both sides, so once I get a new bumper, unfortunately, I'm really bummed about that. I just kind of realized that today. So yeah, it's going to be another few $100. It's going to add up, but I will be going over a full cost breakdown of this vehicle, and hopefully I'll be out nicely on top.